So Kingdom Proteus is given by Ernest Haeckel, and it consists of different types of organisms like photosynthetic decomposers and protozoans. Okay, so types of organisms in Kingdom Proteus. What type of organisms come in Kingdom Proteus? We have read that it have three types of organisms: photosynthetic proteus, decomposer proteus, and protozoans. Okay, photosynthetic proteus have three types further, which are dinoflagellates, euglenoids, and the third one is chrysophytes. Okay, dinoflagellates are unicellular organisms. They have single cell body. Okay, the cell wall made up of cellulose. They have cell wall and it is made up of cellulose. But in chrysophytes, they have no cell wall. Okay, divided into plates. The body of dinoflagellates are divided into plates. They have two flagella. That's why they are called dinoflagellates. Okay, one lies in longitudinal direction, which hangs out. One is in the longitudinal direction, okay, which is hanging out. Second lies in transverse direction between cell wall plates. Okay, the other one is between the transverse plate. Okay, so they have two flagella. Here you can see that the dinoflagellate structure. They have plates on their body. They have a transverse flagella which cover around it. Okay, one is hanging out flagella. Okay, so this is the structure of dinoflagellates, and they are different. There are different types of structures in dinoflagellates. Okay, so dinoflagellates are photosynthetic organisms. They can make their own food. Okay, sexual reproduction occur in these organisms. What does it mean? It means two parents are involved in its reproduction. Okay, organisms like gonialex causes red tide in the oceans, and it also secretes a toxin called sexytoxin, okay, which causes mortality of fishes. It secretes a toxic material which is called sexytoxin, which can cause the death of fishes. Okay, some organisms causes bioluminescence. Example, Noctiluca. Okay, so here we have shown the red tides caused by gonialex. It is not blood, it is gonialex tide. Okay, so it causes the different color of water. It is toxic to the organisms of oceans. Okay, next we will read about euglenoids. They live in fresh water. Okay, their habitat is in fresh water. They are motile with flagella. They can move with the beating of flagella. Okay, they have protein rich layer instead of having cell wall. They have no cell wall, having a single layer of protein which is called pellicle, which makes their body flexible. Okay, euglenoid have two flagella, one short and one long. They have two flagella, which is from which one is short and oneness long. Here we have shown the euglenoid. They have a long flagella, having a short flagella, minute flagella. They have a nucleolus and nucleus, which is surrounded by nuclear envelope. Chloroplast, contractile vacuole, flagellum, stigma, so that they can show the characteristics of plants. Okay, so euglenoids are mixotrophic. What do you mean by that? Mixotrophic are those organisms which can show both the properties of auxotrophic and heterotrophic. So in presence of light they are autotrophic, and in absence of light they are heterotrophic. Reproduction occur by asexual mode. Asexual reproduction is by binary fission in transverse direction. Okay, under favorable condition. So whenever there is favorable condition, they divide by binary fission, which is a part of asexual reproduction. Cell gets transformed into thick walled resting structure. Okay, called cyst. Cell wall transform into thick walled structure, which is called cyst. Under favorable condition, they divide by binary fission, and under unfavorable condition, cell transformed into thick walled resting structure, so that they can't reproduce. Okay. Next, we will read about decomposer protist, in which we discuss about slime molds. They are saprophytic protist. That means they feed upon dead organisms. Under favorable condition, they form an aggregate called plasmodium, which differentiate into fruiting bodies appearing spores on its tip. So it means they also produce spores. Spore possesses cell wall composed of cellulose. They have cell walls having cellulose, so they can show the property of plants. They feed on twigs and leaves, engulfing organic material. They feed upon organic material by engulfing them. Okay. Show features of plants, animals, and fungi. So, here we have shown that slime molds, they have saprophytic body. Okay, they feed on dead materials and grow on dead organisms or dead material. Here you can see the mushroom-like structure, but it is a slime mold. So that's all, guys. In our next video, we will discuss about protozoans, which is the third type of kingdom protist. So for that, please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon. Also press the like button. Thanks a lot.